The initial thing was to get the documentation done, and part of getting the documentation packages like Doxygen and TextLive and so on was it had the side effect of creating all these rebuilds that we need to do. So that's what I'm going to start concentrating on now. And maybe as we go along, we can get rid of a few of these other tabs I've got hanging around still, which are probably part of the rebuild anyway. So as I look down my list here, the first one I've got is libxcb. So I'm going to open up a new tab and search for libxcb. There it is there. So we need to go back into the XC directory for this because it's part of the Xorg libraries. XCB. So these packages are quite small, so this won't take too long. So as you can see, there's a without Doxygen. So we've got the Doxygen this time. We can include that this time and build a package. You can see it's taking a little bit longer now to build because it's got Doxygen to build and now it's finished. So it says adapt check for the tests, and we can now run make check to perform the tests, and that's passed. So we just make install. And that's done. So I'll mark that off on my list and I'll just double check that I've got these marked off on my main list of packages as we're building them. So let's have a look. That was libxcb, so that's xorg. Oh yes, that's already marked off, that's good. Okay, so the next one, just with a dependency of Doxygen, I've got a group of them actually, they're all xcb. Libraries they are, so I can probably go back one here. And the first one I've got is xcbutil. Yeah, it's this little batch here. These are all fairly straightforward. Actually, I'm going to run configure on its own with help and just see if there's an additional option for Doxygen. There is, so we need to add with Doxygen to the configure command. Gem to make use of that. Ampersand make. Well, that was quite quick. It did find it in the config. There it is there. It's built, so just install it. And that was done. Can't even see anything about Doxygen there, but I'm assuming it's done something extra. So that's installed. So I'll mark that one off. It's complete. And the next one is XCB util make. Image, sorry. So again, I'm going to run the configure command. Look for the Doxygen command. Yeah, it's the same as before. So I'm gonna just recall that command. Okay, and to test results, we can do that this time. Okay, and we'll make install, and that's done. Okay, so I'll just mark that off on the list. That's good. And the next one we've got is XCB util key sims. So once again, I'm going to check the config command. Yeah, it's the same. These are all obviously very similar. No test suite, so I'll just make install. That's done. Sorry, XCB. And that's done. XCB render util is the next one. Render util, XCB util. And check for that switch again. Yep. Same as before, and install it. There's no tests. XCB util render util. Okay, next one I've got is util WM. I'll just do the same thing again. So that's done. And last one I've got in this section is XCPU tool cursor, which happens to be the next one. And that's that complete. So they were simple enough. So the next one I've got looks like Doxygen and Wayland. Our Wayland needs Doxygen and Graphviz. We haven't installed Graphviz yet, so I'll ignore that one. Right, JS I've got next. Just needs Doxygen, so let's go back to the index and look for JS. There it is. Yeah, okay, so let's get rid of that highlighting. So back to the BLFS. Extract JS, is it called? No, MozJS. Go into that directory . It says if you're upgrading JS60 from a previously installed old version, save or work and exit your GNOME session if you have one running. Replacing the JS60 binary will cause the GNOME shell to crash and return you to your display manager or TTY. After installing the version, reinstall GJS. Polkit is unaffected. Okay, so we'll reinstall GJS because it looks like we've installed it. So put that in there. Let's have a quick nosy at that one. Oh, maybe we haven't installed it yet then. Let's just have a look. Because it requires GTK and we haven't installed that yet. So GJS. No, it doesn't look like we've got that. So we can ignore that for the moment. So let's start with creating the build directory. Let's add in the config command. Let's just check if there's any other options. No, there isn't. Actually, I should have checked if there was actually a Doxygen switch again. Because a lot of these just say optional Doxygen, but don't actually specify if we need to to run it. So JS source configure dot dot JS source configure help. Oh, crap. So there isn't. So I'm assuming it's picked that up if it needs it. It doesn't say that it has. Quick look through here. A quick glance through, I can't see Doxygen mentioned, but it's not to say that it has picked it out. So I'll just carry on with the build. So I'll just do the make. Okay, so that's built, there's no test. So we'll just install it. And that's done. So that can be marked off. And the next one I've got on the list is libfdev, which I think is part of the X libraries. Oh yeah, Xorg drivers. So let's find that one. So we need, well, because the Xorg fdev driver relies on libfdev, I'm going to install both of these in the correct order. So I'll do the basic driver first of all. So back to XC, I think. Looks like I've forgotten to clear up a few folders there, so I'll just get rid of them first. So let's start with libfdev. So the kernel is going to be configured already, so I don't need to do anything with that. Let's check the configure command for the doxygen flag. Looks like there isn't anything there. Okay, so that means all we can do is run these commands in and assume it is actually using doxygen. Go back there and just check. Yeah, it's building documentation, so assume that's doxygen. So we can run make check. First bit has passed. So that seems to have passed okay. It does say that it can be run as root user, but it may lock up the system. So I'm not going to bother trying that. So let's just do make install now. It's done. So I'll mark that one done. And so I'm just going to reinstall the Xorg driver that relies on the actual libfdev. Mtdev here, I must have installed that as a requirement. Yeah, it is. All inputs, yeah. Okay, so again, I'm just going to check the configure command. Nothing there, so we'll just copy it and install it again. Build and install it again. it's done. So I rebuilt that just for my own sanity, in case anything had changed that might affect this driver, which relies on the other one. Okay, so the next one I've got is libxkb common. So let's find that one. There it is. So this completes all the required, recommended and optional packages by reinstalling this one. We just go back up one. Libxkb. So the enable docs false, but we can remove that now because we've got Doxygen installed. Okay, and we can now do Ninja. Ninja test. That's all okay. And so we can install it. That's done. So mark that as complete. And the next one I've got is libusb. Mark these off. On my paper list. So I've got two lists. I've got one with the, just a reminder, one with the packages as we install them and marking them off to show they're installed. And I've got another list, which is a spreadsheet, which is slightly easier to maintain, which is a list of the packages that need to be rebuilt and a little note as to why they need to be rebuilt. So we're on libxkb common. Just done. So I'm just checking that I have actually already marked that off. And we're now going to do libusb, which is in the same section. There's no extra configuration, we just copy and paste what we've got here. Although this time I'm going to do one extra command to build the documents. No test suite, so we can install. And we've built the API documentation, so we've got a few more commands to do. And we're done there. So mark off my spreadsheet and just double check my installed list. The next one I've got is USB OpenJPEG. OpenJPEG. So this is section 10 now. So no configuration. Just copy and paste the instructions to build. That's done, and we'll install it now. That's complete. Okay, so mark that one off, and it's complete. So that's all the packages I've got, which purely, oh, I've missed one there actually, there's Ruby. Ruby needs to be installed. In fact, I missed a couple looking down, I'm skipping. So there's Libepoxy, Ruby. Yep, so let's do Libepoxy next. So we need to add docs equals true on this one. So don't forget the two dot dots on the meson commands, and we'll just add this option here. Configure it, and looks like we'll just do Ninja to build it. And Ninja test, and Ninja install. It's Libepoxy done. So it looks like that's an X library. Okay. And now we'll do Ruby. All right, we need to rebuild this for Barclay DP. I thought we had that. Just take a look at this list. Right, okay, so I'm not doing Ruby at the moment because that needs Barclay DB. So I'm just going to add that note to my list. So it's after Doxygen and Barclay DB. File is, oh, it's just called DB. We have installed it. Oh yes, because we installed SHA-Util, didn't we? Yeah, I'm pretty sure we've got that as well. Yeah, okay, so we have installed it, so I can do Ruby. Don't remember doing that one for some reason. Right, so let's stop the edit I'm doing here and carry on with this build. I always question what I've written because I'm never sure if I've made a mistake when I've written down or forgotten to write something down. So it's good that when you do double check that it ties up what you've written. So we've got disable some documents. So it looks like we can just copy this because we don't want to disable any documentation now. Hopefully we've got everything that's needed to build those documents. Okay, so that's finished. We can install this CAPI, or generate these CAPI documents. Okay, so that was the API documentation, so now we can run make check to test it. Okay, test finish is one failure. Recognize it as the same as before. In fact, I think there might have been two similar tests before, but we've only got one this time, if that's the case. So at least it's a little bit better than it was before. So I'll take that as a pass and just install it now. Okay, so that is complete. Yep, I'm going to mark that one off. It's done. And I think that's more or less what can be done for now in terms of rebuilding. So my checks through, yeah, a lot of them are relying on other stuff that still needs to be installed. So there's one or two we could do possibly, but I think I might delay them for now. I think what I might do is carry on with these optional packages. These might in fact scoop up some of the packages we've got to rebuild, and they'll probably put in other packages we need to build for some of the desktop environments, window environments, and other applications we're going to install. So it'll be beneficial to do so. Right now, this first one is Ghost Script, and that's quite a heavy duty one. We've already got it installed. We've got it marked down to rebuild for optional packages. Let's have a quick look at that. So things like cups we've got. Cups needs a rebuild as well. With lots of optional packages here. So we've also got all the recommended optional. We've got Cairo, so GTK, libidn. I think I might just look at this GTK. Okay, that's got quite a few dependencies. So quickly, this graph is then. Does this need Ghost Script? Yeah, it does. I think well, we've got to build libgtk at some point, so it may be a good time to build this now anyway. And I think we've got some of these packages need to be installed. Let's have a look at color D. I've got that marked to install with its dependencies. Looks like I've got most of these installed actually, just probably color. GNOME desktop. Right, that's getting into the realms of GNOME. Okay, so I'm not going to do that now. Cups.utils. Icon theme. That would like to have GTK2. What's that got? Okay, let's share some things with GTK3. What might do is start with GTK+2. Because it's going to be one we need to build anyway. Yeah, let's do this one next, I think, and then go back and revisit some of the rebuilds. So let's tidy up here and get this downloading. Alright, sorry, we should really be doing the required packages. Let's find Pango here. Not sure if it needs to be rebuilt. It doesn't. Okay, so we have got that installed. I'll double check that. Oh yes, remember doing this with these extra fonts. Okay, that's definitely done. Where was I? ATK Pango, high color theme. Got these installed. GNOME themes extra. We've got these installed. Right, it says if object introspection was installed after ATK, so basically after the required, which it wasn't, we've already got that installed. Those packages have to be rebuilt before this package can be built. So I think object introspection is quite an early one. We haven't got these two installed. We have got Pango, but that's quite a recent one as well. So we don't need to do that. So let's start with GDK pixbuff, I think. So this has got requirement of glib, gpeg turbo, libpng, shared mime info, libs, librsvg. Libtiff. Okay, libtiff is a one to rebuild, but it's got a few dependencies. Oh, looks like. Oh, yes, it's got free glut. Okay, let's have a look at these. Free glut. Oh, have we got glue? Have we done these? We haven't. See once again how easy it is to get lost in the sort of dependency maze. Looks like where we get going again. Oh, we've already got that one installed, haven't we? Libwebp. So we haven't got that one installed. It looks like we've got a lot of dependencies installed. Let's check. LS. JPEG Turbo we've got. PNG. TIFF. SDL. Right, we haven't got SDL installed. We haven't got free glut yet, but that's one to install. And giflib. Yeah, we've got that one. Okay, so SDL's pulling in a lot of sound-related stuff. So let's take a look at these. Check each one of these. Definitely got the X-Window system. PTH. I think we've done this one, yeah. Pulse audio, nice big one. Lib sound file, lib. No, we haven't got that one. What's the lib? Dplus we've got, e-login, we've got, glib we've got, libcap, speaks we haven't got, XAUD libraries, Afahi. Blues, yeah, I think these is coming back round to stuff we've not yet installed or we need to rebuild. I think Pulse Audio is going to be a rebuild for the optional stuff. I think that'll be a good thing to do. Speaks needs libog. So we can fulfill that. House lib, we can do. Lib sound files got FLAC and Vorbis. House lib. FLAC. Okay. Lib arc oxygen text live. Don't need certain things out of that, so. That would be a rebuild for the documentation. NASM, I think we've got that one. Yeah, we don't need that one. Glue needs Mesa, we've got that. ALSA, that's a suite of libraries, like the looks of it. A-lib. That's GPM, which we installed right up early on. We've got that. Slang, I think we did. Maybe not. PNG. I think we've got PCRE, I'm sure we've done. Yep. Lib PNG, I'm sure we've got that, yeah. Same A lib. STL. WebP. Freeglut. LibTiff. Yeah, I think this is one we've got to rebuild, so we can do that now, the looks of it. LibRSVG, LibCroco, got the rest of that. Looks like we've got that. PixPuff, Jasper we haven't got. Freeglut auction, yeah, we've got all that, or we'll have very soon. ATK, Gnome themes extra, high color theme, and then we're back to GTK plus 2. So by installing some of these, I think we're going to be covering the dependencies of GTK plus 3, which is good. Obviously, it's got its own ones, but so for example, there's high color theme there. So let's go through all these back to front. Quite a few packages to get on with here. And I think we can do all of them. I think there's just one identified that we'd have to reinstall for a particular reason. I can't remember which, but we'll see that when we come to it. So let's start with libog. Let's fetch this. So there's no special commands here, we'll just build and make it. Make check, it's okay, sudo minus e make install. It's done. So that was chapter 42. It's libog. So it's the first audio related library we've installed there. Now we've got one called Speaks. Two downloads here. So it says the package consists of two separate tarballs that need to be extracted and built independently. So we've got the first one, which is called Speaks, and the second one's called Speaks DSP. So this has got an extra configuration command, enable binaries, builds two binaries to encode and decode to and from the Speaks format. So let's try and put that in. And make to build it. And make install. Now we go back and create the Speaks DSP package. So I'm going to try and put that enable binaries on this, see if it works or not. So it doesn't say specifically which package it should go against. It hasn't complained about it. Oh, right, okay, it didn't recognize it for this one, so that's okay. as it was for the first one. So let's just make and install it. So that's that package done. So we've got two separate packages to remove here. Speaks 120 and speaks DSP 120. So it's done. So this again, is it in the same area? 42 it is. So I'll cross that off. And next one I've got is ALSA lib. So while that's downloading, we've got some configuration to check in the kernel. So cd into the sources and linux make menu config. We need to go to device drivers, sound card support, which is normally about a page or two down. There it is there. Advanced Linux sound architecture. And then we need to select settings and drivers appropriate for your hardware, so it's pretty fuzzy as to what you need to select here. Now, because we're using a generic default settings for the sound, it should all work. The only exception would be possibly these here. You'd really have to check. It's ultimately the hardware that you've got. So if you've got a PCI device, you'll need to select one of these. This has got HD audio, and generally it's Realtek for the Intel hardware. So I'm going to take a punt at having that module. So I'll press M to modularize it. You can actually auto-load this one. Some of these hardware drivers have to be installed as modules, and some will work as a module or built in. So let's save that. I'm going to rebuild the kernel. It shouldn't take too long. I think it should just build the little bit to do with the sound. Maybe not. It looks like it's going to be building a lot. So just wait for this to finish. Okay, that's rebuilt, so all we need to do is copy the new image back to the boot. Now what would be a good idea, I should have shown this earlier actually, is to take a copy of the current image in case what we've done to the kernel causes the new kernel to stop booting. If we just overwrite the one we booted from, then obviously we can't boot into the machine anymore, so that's a bit of an issue. So it's probably a good idea to either back up your kernel and the system map file, and maybe even the config file, each time you update the kernel, or just take a copy of a working one, a working version, and create a copy of that. Probably best if you do a backup each time, because then you've got an incremental, you know, the previous version that worked, rather than just taking one and keep using that one. But however you do that, it's up to you. But what I'm going to do is just copy these files as they are. Something like that. So I should have two copies of the same kernel. Now, if I go back and copy the new kernel into the boot and overwrite the current one that's pointed at by the grub.config, and same for the system map, and optional, and copy the config file as well. So now if we look at the boot directory, you can see that the config, the new one's slightly smaller for some reason, don't know why. And the system map, the new one's slightly bigger than the old one, and so is the new kernel. It's slightly bigger by approximately 50k or so. So that's that done. Now I just noticed while that was compiling that it said also to check that the deprecated option was not selected. So let's go back to device drivers, sound card support, advanced Linux. Yeah, it's this one here, enable sound card support. Open sound system is not selected. Well, it's that one there, I think. It's obviously not called that option anymore. It maybe was once. So it isn't selected, so that's good. We can also do the /forward/ to do a search for OSS. It may bring other things up. Yeah, it has possible. Loss possible. But if you quickly look through. Yeah, see sound, OSS emulation, mixer OSS, they're all set to no, so that's good. OSS plugins, sequencer OSS, sound OSS core, etc. So that does look like it isn't set, so we don't need to make any further changes there. So let's now, we've installed it. We could reboot, it's not absolutely necessary at the moment. We don't need the sound at the moment if it was to enable sound. So let's just go back and start installing Elsa libs. So there's no additional conf options, configure options, so it's just configure and make. And make a doc for the documentation and install it. And then install the API documentation too. The alsolib package needs to be installed to link against some libraries. Now that alsolib is installed, if you wish to run tests, make checks. So I'm going to do this as the normal user. And there's two tests there and they've passed, so that's all done. Okay, so that is chapter 42, alsolib. So lib4bis, this might be the one that needed to be rebuilt because of, it looks like it needs extra. So I'm presuming these are the programs that are part of TextLive, optional programs. Oh no, they are separate. Or part of the standard TextLive install. Okay, so we can do this one, no problem. So let's begin by downloading it. So I can add enable docs to configure to build the documentation. And build it. And check it. And, oh, what's happened there? Not sure what it needs there. Util TPO. Let's do a config. That's better. Okay, I needed the cache renewing for the checks, for the libraries, so they could run the tests. So that looks like it's passed. It says system return 0. So we can install it. This has failed. Looks like it has managed to create the PDF latex. PDF. I wonder why it's not found that. No such file or directory. Right, looks like the path's not valid. Let's try sourcing the path. Okay, now let's try the install again. That's better. Okay, I think that's done. So libvorb is done, and what section are we in now? 42 still, so libvorbis. Now we can install flak. So disable thorough tests. To test results, make check. Note that if you pass the enable exhaustive test and enable Valgrind testing parameters to configure and then run the test will take a very long time, up to 300 SPUs and use about 375 mega disk space. So I'm going to do that. Some of these estimates have been a bit over the top what I've seen so far, so I'm going to hope that this one is as well. And see what happens. Enable exhaustive tests. Okay, so guys, let's see how long this takes to test. Okay, well, that looks like it might have failed one particular test there. Not sure if there's any indication if that was the end of the testing or if that was the failure at the end there. There's lots of files in that directory. Obviously, if this was something that was important to you, then you'd have to investigate what the source of the error was and fix it. Yeah, I'm not sure which of those it was actually running on. So, like I say, that would be something that would need to be investigated. As it's just a sound package, it's not really a great deal of concern to me for this instance. But obviously, like I say, if I was using it seriously, then it would have to be investigated as to why it was failing and whether it was a genuine error or not. What could do is... we can build this again with a short test and see if they fail in the same way, which would probably indicate there is definitely a problem there, rather than just a potential problem with something more advanced. So if I go back and remove the directory and re-extract it, and then just copy the default configure and then run make check. Now if it does pass, I mean, all that means is maybe something's not being tested on, something's not being tested as comprehensively, so it's not all well and good, but it does indicate that in the main that the program would run as expected. So it does look like it's passed with the less aggressive testing. So, like I say, it depends on how important this package is to you. And obviously, if it is, then you need to investigate with the enhanced testing as to whether that can be fixed or not. So let's install the package. And that can be tidied up now and closed down. So now we can build libsound file. Let me just mark off that flag. Libsound file. So let's download it and extract it. And just straightforward configure, make, check, and install. Make check. Okay, and we can install it. And that's it. So it's libsound file. So now we've got pulse audio. So we've got all of these dependencies in, except for the optional. So this is one I'm going to add to my rebuild list because some of the optional were quite intensive in terms of what needed to be built. So this is pulse audio, and this will be rebuilt after the optional packages have been installed. And, you know, by the time we come to install this, it could be that a lot of them, if not all of them, have been installed, or we've had to install them for other reasons. So let's start by downloading this. And extracting it. So we've got some descriptions here. Because it looks like we need these. There's nothing extra to add, so let's just copy this. So obviously next time round, when we've got blues installed, we can remove the switches, or at least the blues 5.1. Okay, so we can test this. So that looks like a pass, so we can now install. Make install. And it says here also to remove a config file to stop creating unnecessary system users and groups. So let's put that in as well. It's done. There's a little bit about configuring there. I mean, I could get the sound working to demonstrate it. I might do that, but it's not really of a concern at the moment. So that's pulse audio. And that needs to be reinstalled. So now onto glue. We've already got Mesa, so we can just save this and build it. Quite a simple package. So there's no testing, so we just install this directly, and that's done. And that one's under X libraries, I think it was. Julio. Now we've got the ALSA suite of libraries. So this is section 42. Now we've obviously already done ALSA lib. So what called for this? It just says ALSA 121. ALSA 121, okay. So it's the following six sections of the book deal with the separate components of ALSA, the libraries, the plugins, the utilities, the tools, the firmware, and the ISS compatibility libraries. So it's one, the first one we've done, lib, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, they all begin ALSA. So let's go through the first six packages. So as I've already done ALSA lib, next one's the plugins. So this needs FFmpeg, I'm sure that's got lots of dependencies. Yeah, it has, so I'm going to leave that one for the moment. In fact, these are all optional. I'm going to build the plugins and they're going to be rebuilt later. After optional packages. So let's start this off. No fancy configs, and we can build it. and install it. And tidy up. So that's our plugins, which we're going to rebuild. This one, LC Tills. Again, it's got a few FFTW. Let's look at that one. That's got a few. Oh no, that can go in. That's got no dependencies. Lib sample rate. Lib sound final FFTW for the test. Okay, we can do that one as well. So LC Tills will be fulfilled. So let's download FFTW. We build FFTW three times for four different libraries and different numerical positions. The default double position floating point. The older 32-bit single position version named float, which sacrifices precision for speed, and the long double, which offers increased precision at the cost of slower execution. Okay, so the first one is for double precision. Let's just check what options we've got. We can enable shared threads. Enable float. And then we're on double, so that's obviously the different detail they're compiling for. And it looks like unless your processor doesn't support these, you don't need to touch anything. If it don't support these CPU features, then you would need to leave them off. And you can find out if your processor does support those features by catting proc CPU info, and amongst this flags bit you'll find these flags after enable bits. So for example, SSE2 is there, and AVX there's AVX2, there's AVX there, so you could cat that and grep for those two flags, and if they don't appear then you need to leave out, or maybe even put in disable and then the flag. So SSE2, you see it's on each core, and AVX as well. And indeed you might want to take a punt at running configure with help to see if there are any other flags that you might want to turn on. For example, AVX2 might be supported. In fact, it is. So you can see SSE2 enables SSE and SSE2 optimizations. But for AVX2, it just says enable AVX2. So arguably, we could add in, or certainly on this processor, if you see, it's got AVX2 as well, so I might add that in. AVX2. And build it. Okay, so that's built. So we can do make check to test it. Okay, so that's finished testing. Let's install this first suite of programs. So that was a single precision. So now, that was the double precision. Now we're going to build the single. So we clean the source folder and I'll recall the configure command because it looks the same. Enable threads SEC2, AVX, enable AVX2, and then the only difference between this and the previous is this enable float. Now it doesn't look like they're testing this, so I guess the assumption is that it's been tested once. There's no point in testing it again, so I suppose it's up to you whether you wish to test it or not. Okay, so now we can install it. And then go on to build the last one, which hasn't got the SSE or AVX. So I'm just going to copy this configure that's here and the make. It implies that they're not needed or it won't work. That's installed, built, so now install it, and that is that package finished. So FFTW, now we're on to libsample rate. Looks like this is a bit slow. Yeah, I did do it. I was doubting whether I'd clicked on it or not then. Okay, so libsample rate. No extra config commands, just straightforward. And we can test this and check. It's done, it says all tests passed, so all I need to do is install it. And that's done. Lib sample rate. Okay, that's done. So now we're back to ALSA utils. We've got all the dependencies in place. Pretty sure we've done XMLTO. Let me just check. Yeah. So let's fetch this package. Alright, disable the ALSA config tool, which is compatible with UDEF. Disable XMLTO. Right, we've got XMLTO installed, so we can remove that one and this one as well. Omit the switch if you installed FFTW and wish to install the BAT basic audio tester. So we need to copy that line and that bit there. No test suite, so we just do make install. And that's the ALSA tool, ALSA utilities complete. ALSA utils. So now we move on to, there's some configuration here. Note the channels are sound going to be by default. Yeah, that's worth bearing in mind actually. It's ALSA, if you're on ALSA mixer. Okay, looks like the sound might not be configured properly, probably because we need to reboot for the kernel update that we did. So when we've done this little bit, we can reboot and get that working. ALSA control programs normally run from standard UDEV rule. The first time it was run, a complaint, there's no state in the file lib ALSA A sound state. You can prevent this by running the following commands as the root user. So let's run that to prevent that warning from happening. So it actually says no sound cards found at the moment. Heading users might use the sound devices to this audio group. So let's do that. Bearing in mind that this won't be active until we log in again as Kernotex. But at least it will be there next time. And there's a boot script to restore the volume settings at boot up. So let's become the root. Let's just do SU. And go to the boot scripts, BLFS. It's CD BLFS. Boot scripts and make install ALSA. In theory, should be able to start this now, though it may fail because it can't find a sound card. Yeah, it hasn't been able to. So that's the utilities done. Next we've got the ALSA tools. So this has got some optional packages, but we need GTK 2 and 3. We're building GTK 2 and 3 currently, so this has got to be added to our list of packages to rebuild. to get the extra tools. But for the time being, we can just install what it can. Right, looks like there's several tools here. Have I downloaded this? Saving as. No. So let's go back here. Let's check I've cleaned up. Yep. So it says when installing multiple packages and scripts, installation needs to be done as a root user. So it's got this script again. So I'm hoping this is going to be intelligent enough to know what we have got and what we haven't got. So let's add this function. Start with bash minus e to exit on an error. Remove a tool that needs Qt 2 or 3 and 2 unneeded files. Adapt some tools to ouslib 1212 and Linux 5.4. House tool packages is needed by those with advanced requirements for their sound card. Tools can be built all together at once, but if only a subset is needed, you need to cd into the directory of each tool you wish to compile and run commands. Here we present instructions to build all the tools, so this may fail because we haven't got the options. So let's see what happens. Yes, it has failed, so we can't actually complete this at the moment. And so, let's do exit. Oh, of course, that shut it down, hasn't it? Okay. Probably the best thing for me to do is to quit this and restart the session. And delete the ELSA tools directory. Oops. Let's just check that did the whole lot. So I need to add a note to build this when so build build ELSA tools after GTK plus 2, GTK plus 3, and FLTK. FLTK have been built. As I say, we're focusing on, I think, GTK 2 at the moment, and then ultimately GTK 3 as well. So, tools needs to be built. So I've just got two more, firmware and OSS. Alright, this is requirement is tools. We haven't got tools, so we're going to have to put a note to build this after ELSA tools. So build ELSA firmware after ELSA tools. And ELSA RSS It's also lib. So this is for programs which use a compatibility library of OSS. So let's grab this one now. Save link as. And quite a straightforward installation. A test suite, so sudo minus e make install, and that's done.